Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, Fight fans. Welcome back. Let's just dig right into it. Andy Ruiz Jr. is making excuses for his loss to Anthony Joshua. And let's just break it down honestly, unbiased, and objectively as possible. Remember, facts can't be biased. And you see that Andy Ruiz Jr. states, you know, for this fight, I was overweight. I should have trained harder. I should have listened to my coaches more. Maybe I shouldn't have put on all this weight that I did. That's a direct quote from Andy Ruiz Jr. Another quote from Andy Ruiz Jr. was, you know, I was overweight, man. Everyone told me I was too heavy, but I didn't listen. I think the partying got to me. You know, one of his biggest excuses at this point is that he overtrained, he let the weight get to him, and he lost simply because he came in heavy. Now, while I do believe that was a factor in why he lost, he did that as a strategic way to try to win the fight. And not only that, to say that he didn't train is ludicrous. We all know Andy Ruiz Jr. was training. We understand. He even stated that he had a 3-month camp, you know, preparing for this earlier than he normally would. He also stated, you know, we've got sparring partners running around being slick. A lot of people came to me and that said they wanted to help me, like Michael Hunter. The only thing I'm doing differently is sparring. So basically, he's doing all the same things that he did in the prior camp, but this one is just sparring. He says, I've got a lot of different sparring partners in case he tries to switch up his style, in case he tries to box or keep me away with the jab. We're practicing. And that's exactly what Anthony Joshua did. Put on a boxing masterclass, kept him away with the jab, and he practiced all of these things. He went over all of these things. So for him to come out and say that he wasn't in shape, but he did everything the same, he's contradicting himself. It makes no sense. He also stated, I almost had a 3-month camp for this fight. We've got more things done. We've practiced what AJ is going to do. And obviously the practicing didn't help because he was completely and utterly dominated in that fight. You know, Anthony Joshua landed the jab at will, landed the power shots at will. You know, Andy Ruiz Jr. was hesitant to let his hands go. He was slow. And a lot of people finally see that Anthony Joshua's footwork is elite, while Andy Ruiz Jr. footwork is just nowhere near that level. He has elite level hand speed, but footwork and foot speed is just not there. A lot of people say that, oh, he got better footwork than Anthony Joshua. That's nonsense. He has better foot speed than Anthony Joshua. That's nonsense. As you can see, when Anthony Joshua has better foot speed and better footwork than Andy Ruiz Jr., Andy Ruiz Jr. was struggling to cut off the ring. Anthony Joshua was literally putting on a boxing masterclass. And then you even see Andy Ruiz Jr. states that, you know, he's willing to go so far as to die in the ring to keep those belts. But at no time did you see Andy Ruiz Jr., you know, go for broke in the ring and say, you know what, I'm just going to try to knock out Anthony Joshua right now and give it everything I got. No, he simply didn't do that. And the reason why I didn't believe he did that was because he knew that he would have eventually got caught and countered and maybe dropped or hurt or even knocked out. He did not want to risk it all against Anthony Joshua. He was hesitant, and you know, he was timid at times. And a lot of people want to say that Anthony Joshua was moving. Anthony Joshua was consistently hitting and touching Andy Ruiz Jr. all night long. It's unfortunate for Andy Ruiz Jr. that he couldn't get inside of that jab. He couldn't get it in work. That's not Anthony Joshua's problem. Joshua's problem is to hit and not get hit. It is the art of boxing. Andy Ruiz Jr. is simply making excuses for a humiliating loss, a loss in which he was dominated and exposed to a degree. We have to be honest and unbiased. Once again, it's the IBFP.